Hello everyone, and welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to 30 Days of Pride, where I am highlighting Trailblazers, an event in our Pride's history that allows us to celebrate Pride the way we do today in 2020. Yay! Today we're going to be talking about the Trailblazer Harvey Milk that I promised a couple days ago when we talked about the White Knights riot. So Harvey Milk was not the first openly LGBT plus person to hold public office in the United States, but he was definitely the most influential when it came to policy making towards the community and his activism. He shaped a lot of queer resistance of the time, even before he was on the board of San Francisco's government. In 1978, Harvey Milk helped introduce the city's first LGBT plus rights ordinance, which Milk referred to as the most stringent gay rights law in the country. The ordinance banned discrimination in employment, housing, and public accommodations based on sexual preference. Milk's work in the late 70s towards Proposition 6 and defeating it was known as the Briggs Initiative because it was proposed by former California Representative John Briggs. This prop was to ban the employment of any teacher in the state who was gay or supported gay rights. And that Briggs initiative lost by more than a million votes. And as we talked about in the last video, Milk was assassinated in 1978, less than a year into his term, by Dan White. So I want to talk about a little background in San Francisco at the time that Harvey Milk came to public office and why he was so pro-LGBT rights at the time. So in the 1960s, DOB, which I talked about a couple videos ago, and the Society for Individual Rights began to work against the prosecution of gay bars and entrapment in San Francisco from the police. Oral sex was still a felony at the time, and in 1970, nearly 90 people were arrested for having sex in public parks at night. The mayor at the time, Mayor Alioto, asked the police to target parks, hoping that the decision would appeal to the archdiocese and Catholic supporters. In 1971, more than 2,800 gay men were arrested for having public sex in San Francisco. By comparison, New York only had 63 arrests that year. And as I talked about with Bayard Rustin, any arrests that were made at the time for sex in public arrested you for a morals charge and you had to be registered as a sex offender. Harvey Milk became interested in political and civic matters, especially when he was introduced with civic problems and policies that he didn't like. One day in 1973, a state bureaucrat entered the Castro, where Milk lived, and informed him that he owed $100 as a deposit against the state sales tax. Milk got into a fight about him against the rights of business owners, and the deposit was reduced to $30. Harvey Milk ran a camera store, and once a teacher walked in asking for a new projector that he could borrow because the school didn't give him proper equipment, Harvey Milk was a political leader who, at the time where gay men were being arrested by the thousands, stood up and was openly challenging city lawmakers to change the way they thought about gay rights and how discrimination laws affected these people. And he didn't only stand up for gay rights, he stood up for business owners and teachers and the disenfranchised. He's such an important person that documentaries have been made, really good documentaries have been made. You should go watch some. And it shows the power that one person can have. They don't have to grow up in politics, they don't have to be the most powerful, charismatic person, they just need to have a fire inside of them that wants to change the world. So thank you, Harvey Milk. We will always remember you. Thank you for letting us celebrate Pride the way we do today. I will see you all tomorrow when we talk about a new Trailblazer. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to give it a like and subscribe down below. You can follow all my social media links down below as well. And I will see you all tomorrow. Bye.